Revenge by Nick Ferris. Read by Joy Gelardi. Revenge. 101 things to do when you've been dumped. What did the cannibal do after he dumped his girlfriend? He wiped his arse. Revenge offers an amusing guide to the opportunities open to the person who suddenly finds themselves single again, and is quite frankly, pissed off about it. How do you get back at the person who dumped you? Well, look no further. There are many different ways. Some are funny, some are silly, many are disgusting, some are dangerous, some are unthinkable. This book has them all, plus a few more. Dumping happens to us all. The royals, the pope, presidents, rock stars, dentists, funeral directors, road sweepers, bankers, jockeys, even Wombles and Teletubbies get dumped. This book is for all of you and those in between. Revenge takes no responsibility for any actions whatsoever of anyone dead, alive, human, alien, or just plain dumb. Revenge. Get your partner into a drunken stupor and cut their hair off. Which body part you shave depends on the severity of your feelings. Suicidal? All body hair. Depressed? Groin and legs. Damaged ego? Eyebrows. Revenge. Invent a time machine. Go back and dump your ex 10 minutes before they dumped you. Please note, instructions to build a time machine have not been included with this pocket guide due to time constraints. Revenge. Cook a wholesome homemade pie with dog food. Whether or not you tell them is up to you. If they are prone to projectile vomiting, have a bucket ready when you tell them face to face. Then run. Revenge. Just say, it was love at first sight, but then I took another look. Revenge. Phone up the Australian speaking clock. Sneak into your ex's house and call the Australian speaking clock when they're at work, leaving it off the hook. Sex lines in Colombia work just as well, but your ex may like that, though. Revenge. Put your ex's name down for a music club so they end up buying overpriced CDs for the rest of their life. If you're really clever, you can keep the 5 free CDs offered, and they will have to buy Editor's Choice of Country Classics every month for a year. Do a Jerry Halliwell. Go on a crash diet and then go out with much better looking people than your ex. Revenge. While your ex is on holiday, turn them into a star. Rig their house up with Big Brother-style webcams and broadcast their habits to the world on their return. But don't tell them. Leave a note on your ex's doorstep for the milkman. Declare their undying love for him and ask him out for a date. Revenge. Hold a party. Invite everyone you know and everyone your ex knows, apart from your ex. Cook crispy fried worms as part of a farewell dinner. Nice with mayonnaise. Use the gift of tattoo. Get your ex inebriated beyond belief and take them to a tattoo parlour. Suggestions: for sale, sold, I'm gay, kick me. Revenge. Say it with pizza. Call your local pizza parlour, tell them you're having a party and order 40 pizzas with extra toppings they hate. Works even better if they don't like pizza. Revenge. Spend your ex's money on mail-order catalogues, irons, cheap bedspreads or mobile phone deck chairs. Only buy things you know they hate, don't need, can't afford and or don't fit. Anything that hits all 4 revenge categories is perfect. Revenge. Hire a hypnotist to hypnotise your ex and make them beg for forgiveness to have you back. Good opportunity to get rid of all those bad habits too. Revenge. Go out with one of your ex's parents so you can execute parental power over them. The ultimate revenge. Make them go to bed at 7 o'clock. That kind of thing. Revenge. Send an embarrassing note to your ex's parents. Whilst complimenting them on their choice of tie-back frilly curtains, casually drop in lines such as, "Your son or daughter's constant desire."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.